So let's talk about origin of a Netflix and how Netflix dominated the market coming at around 1997, and it was founded by Reed Hastings as a paper rental mail order video rental company. After experimenting with both paper rental and subscription, the company settled on a subscription-based strategy by the end of 1999. By 2010, Netflix had 13 million members and was world's largest subscription service. By 2020, it has surpassed that amount by a large margin. Sending DVDs by mail and streaming movies and television episodes over the internet. For $8.99 a month, Netflix members could have more than 1 lakh DVD titles delivered to their homes and could instantly watch a smaller set of television episodes and movies streamed to their televisions and computers. Netflix shipped some 2 million discs daily in the United States during their initial stages, which is now totally converted into an OTT platform. Netflix focused its strategy around offering a large variety of titles, helping customers navigate titles with a sophisticated random and recommendation engine, and ensuring that the title reached customers quickly. Whereas a brick and mortar rental store type typically carried about 3,000 titles, in 2010, Netflix offered its customer a selection of more than 1 lakh DVD titles, most of which were old releases. In 2009, about 70% of the DVDs shipped by Netflix were titles with release date older than 13 weeks. And you have seen it now, there are so many platforms which have emerged with Netflix coming into business that we have now 3 to 4 OTT platforms which are going neck to neck with Netflix, like Hotstar, Prime Video, G5, and many more. So in 2010, during the early stages, Netflix has about 60 regional distribution centers across the United States with sophisticated system to track customer DVD queues, as the distribution center process were linked to the recommendation software. Movies that were likely to be in stock were recommended to customers. When the distribution center received a watched DVD back from a customer, a new one from the customer rental queue was shipped out. These distribution centers were highly automated for rapid processing and were located within the driving distance of several US Postal Service processing facilities. Netflix estimated that it would spend around $600 million in 2010 on shipping expenses. Netflix ability to rent older titles was very appealing to studios that had historically seen little revenue from this content. Netflix bought older DVDs from studios at a cost and in turn provided them a percentage of the subscription revenue based on utilizing for rentals over a specific period, typically 6 to 12 months. For newer content, Netflix did not attempt to serve the entire initial rush of rental demand. Given the higher initial cost of purchase, the company purchased only a limited number of new releases DVDs, preferring instead to wait for a few weeks and buy the bulk of its supply at lower cost. Customer could put new titles into their queues and receive them when the DVD become available in stock. Between 2005 and 2009, Netflix delivered excellent financial results and grew revenue by 150% and profits by 175%. Despite strong performance in its DVD rental business, however, the company was focused on increasing the fractions of digital content it delivered. Its streaming service, which was launched in 2007, allowed customers to watch select movies and content on Netflix website via their PCs. By 2009, the Netflix service offered them more than 1700 titles, and now I cannot even tell you how many titles they have and how many regions, how many countries they have spread across. If you have seen, there is a TV show called Money Heist, Dark, and Sacred Games in India, and they have been loving worldwide. The stars, which has no connection with the movie industry whatsoever, now they are coming. A normal boy can come and perform and can get reputation instead of a wide variety of audience. As Nawazuddin Siddiqui said in the recent interview, that whenever you publish a movie in the theater, you will not get a seat or a movie show, and if you get a movie show, you will get around 11 a.m. or 11 p.m. But in a Netflix movie streaming service, this movie will be there. The audience has to choose which movie they have to watch at any given point of time. So that actually happens when if there is no matter if the movie is made from thousand of crores or just of 5 crores, if the movie is good, its rating is good, that means the content is good. That's how the movie business, the Netflix has completely changed the movie business. Let's move ahead on other topic, and I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please do give us a thumbs up. Please subscribe. We will be trying to give you more informational content on supply chain, logistics, everything, whatever we can, we will give you. But for that, we need your support. So please do keep liking us, subscribing us, and sharing our videos. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.